Juliet.
We're with the Winkle, and today we're making paper. Can you believe we're making paper today?
Yeah, I do not know how paper is made.
Well, we're going to find all that out today. It's going to be so fun.
Woohoo!
Yeah, should we see what's in our kit?
Yes. Paper, screen, thumbtacks, and a container.
Right, on top of everything in your kit, all you'll need is a box. You can use your Winkle box or any other sort of box, but you need to make sure that your screen can fit over at the top of it. And you'll need a cup of water, but that's not till later. So once you have your box, we're ready to get started.
Woohoo!
Juliet, this project today is all about fibers. Can you say that word?
Fibers.
Yeah. Fibers are like hairy looking things that you see on the edge of the paper when you tear it. Let me show you. Like that, when you tear that paper,
it looks like hair.
Yes, that's right. Those little tiny pieces, those are all called fibers. Your shirt also has fibers. Can you kind of see that it's kind of fuzzy? Most paper is made from wood. Did you know that? Like a tree.
Yeah.
So that's why it's important to recycle, which we're going to be talking about today too, because recycling means we don't have to cut down as many trees.
Yeah.
In the wood, those fibers are called cellulose. Can you say that?
Yeah, cellulose.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Thicker paper usually has a thicker texture and thicker fibers, but this paper has really thin, small fibers, but if you had like a magnifying glass or something like that, you could see up close those little thin fibers, right? And in the end, when we're done with this project, we're going to be making a piece of paper just like this. Isn't that cool?
Feels like paper.
Yeah, it is. And you can cut it and you can even draw on it if you want. So we're going to start by making our screen. Okay, we're going to start with our Winkle box and we're putting the screen over the top of it like this. Now, we're going to be putting a lot of wet paper on top of this, and so the screen can sag. So we're going to make sure it's nice and tight when you're putting in the push pins. Your first push pin is going to go in the middle. See that? And then when you do your second push pin, you're going to go on the opposite side, pulling hard so it's nice and tight. See how tight that is? So right now we have opposite sides with push pins in them. Then we're going to go to the other sides, pull it hard, put in a push pin.
Can I try?
Yeah, so pull it hard.
Right here?
Yep. I'm pulling hard, put in the push pin.
That was so easy.
Yeah, it sure was. Okay, so now the screen is pretty secure, but we're going to secure it even more with the rest of our push pins.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to put the push pins on either side. Nope, a little farther to the left.
Right there?
Yeah. So we're going to go kind of near the corners of each of our sides of our box.
Right here?
Yes. And see, we're pulling it tight while we're putting the push pins in. Put them near the corners.
Right here?
No, over here. There you go. Mm-hmm. And then one on the left corner.
Right there.
And every time, just make sure you're pulling that screen nice and tight so that there's no stretching going on in here. Two more.
Right here.
Very good. Now we've made a screen. That's what this is. Is it nice and tight? If yours isn't tight at home, you're going to want to readjust your pins, pull that screen fabric even more so that it's nice and tight on top.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Put your screen aside, and now we can grab our container and our paper. Juliet, for our paper making today, we have to tear all of these papers into tiny little pieces, less than an inch big. I tore my paper before into 1-inch pieces, and that did not work because you need all those fibers to be sticking together, and you only get those fibers showing if you tear the paper. Okay, so you can't cut the paper on this, you have to tear. I'm actually just going to do tiny little tears just like that, and I'm gonna put them in my container. Do you wanna help me, Juliet?
Sure.
All right. This is fun because you get to tear paper.
I love tearing things.
I know. Remember when you tore a piece of our sofa? And you tore some books before?
Yeah.
This tearing is okay to do, not like the other kind of tearing that you do sometimes. So start tearing your paper while I talk to you a little bit more about fibers and cellulose. So what is cellulose? Because cellulose is what gives all plants their structure, most plants can be used to make paper. Since the Chinese produced the first true paper around the year 100 AD, people have made paper with rags, fishing nets, grass, tree bark, and a variety of other plants. You may be wondering how all those little scraps of paper stuck together again make a whole new sheet of paper. Paper is made of fibers that come from wood. Cellulose fibers are slightly sticky, so they help paper hold together. In fact, cellulose is used to make some kinds of glue. You can even recycle old paper by blending it up into tiny pieces. Those pieces of paper were made from cellulose fibers. The warm water we're going to add to our container makes the cellulose sticky again. Then when you press your new sheet of paper together, the fibers get matted down and tangled together. Then they get stuck to each other as they dry into a new sheet of paper.
I love ripping.
I know you do.
This is a lot of paper.
It sure is. So you guys at home, you understand how little your pieces need to be and that they need to be all torn up. You need to tear all three pieces of paper. So while you're doing that, you can pause the video and then press play when all your pieces are torn. That was a lot of ripping.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys at home, make sure all your pieces are really tiny, no more than an inch big. Now you'll need to go get a cup of warm water. It doesn't have to be super hot that it hurts your fingers, but it should be warm water, and we're going to add it to our paper. Okay, so we have our cup of warm water, and we're going to pour it into our paper. Do you want to do it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do I pour all of
it? Yep, all of it in. Okay, so we actually did like a cup and a half of water because you want to make sure your container's filled up, but not to the top, about an inch from the top, because you want to make sure we have enough room to shake this around. So put your lid on and then give that a good shake. This shaking is called agitating, and your paper has to be agitated in order to make those fibers stick together. So the warm water is going to help and the agitation is going to help. To make strong paper, you need long fibers, which is why the pulp has to be beaten up quite a bit. Beating the cellulose separates the fibers from each other while leaving individual fibers intact. You're going to want to shake your paper about every hour or every 2 hours for the next day or so. You want to make sure all those fibers are nice and pulpy because that's the way your paper is going to stick together when we put it on our screen. So you're going to let this sit and every hour or two give it a nice good shake, and then tomorrow we will put all the paper out on our screen. Okay, Juliet, our paper has been sitting in our container. We actually waited 2 days because it wasn't quite ready after day one. So it just depends on how warm your water was, how much you were able to shake it up, and if you're able to wait 1 or 2 or even 3 days, you just want to make sure your paper is nice and pulpy like this. Do you see that?
Can I feel?
Yes.
Wow, it feels so weird.
Yeah, it feels mushy and kind of gross. But even as you're squeezing it, you're putting that paper back together because those fibers are going to reattach to each other. Remember those fibers that we were learning about? So we here at the Winkle Studio do not have a sink near us, but we do have this towel that we laid down and some paper towel. But if you have a sink, if you're at your house and you have a sink nearby, you might want to go do this over by your sink because there will be a lot of water and your hands will get really messy with the paper and you're going to want to wash them off right after. Okay, so you're going to grab some of that mushy paper and you're going to put it on your screen. Yep, you just want to do it in little pieces. If you do it in one big piece, it won't spread out as nicely. So a bunch of little pieces. You don't want to squeeze out too much of the water either. Just put it on with the water in there, very watery. See how the water is dripping into our box? We're going to just let that water be there for right now. So see how we're making a little rectangle? If you need to separate some of your papers, kind of move your papers around so that you can make that rectangle. We're not smashing it yet, We're just trying to make that rectangle first. Okay, see how I'm covering up any holes that I might see anything where you can see that screen, you want to cover it up because that will be a hole in your paper and it'll actually make your paper not so strong. But see how thick this is? Oh, I see a thin spot right here. I'm going to add a little paper there. There's a thin spot right here, so I'm going to add a little paper there. Don't worry if you don't have a perfect rectangle, because later on when your paper dries, you can actually cut the edges to make a good looking rectangle, to make it nice and smooth on the edges.
Wow, the paper is very, very sticky.
Yes, it really is. All right, now see how we have just mostly this pulpy water left. We don't have very many pieces of paper left.
Yep.
This is why you might need a sink at your house, because we are going to pour this pulpy water over our paper. That way we can collect all of those extra starches and fibers that are in that papery water.
Do we have to pour all of it?
Yes. We're going to pour it over here. Now, if you have a sink at home, you'll do this over the sink and all that water will drain right into your sink. And then the screen will catch all of the papers.
That's all it.
That's
a lot.
That's a lot of water in there.
Yeah.
What we're gonna do is we don't wanna touch this with our hands, because then our paper will start sticking to our hands. But we can take the flat edge of this container, just kind of scoot the paper together.
Can I try, Mom?
Yep, and you're just gonna kind of squeeze it out. You don't want to squeeze out too much, because then the paper will start sticking to your container. And we're just squeezing out a little bit of water, just gently pressing. So with all that extra water you have in your box, you can just tilt your box just a little bit and collect it in the sink or back into your container. You don't want to turn the box all the way up, because what will happen to your paper that we're making?
It'll fall.
It'll fall off. It'll just plop right off. So yeah. Just give your box a little tilt, and that way you can drain that water out of the bottom of your box. Now, Juliet, see how we need this screen to be nice and tight? While it's drying, if you notice your screen starts sagging, like drooping, you're gonna tighten up your screen so that it's not sagging anymore. Okay, so you wanna watch this while it's drying to make sure the screen is nice and tight. Okay, we're gonna wait probably 2, maybe even 3 days. We're gonna keep watching this paper and we're gonna wait until it's all dry. You do not wanna take it off the screen until it's completely dry. If you take it off before it's dry, guess what will happen?
It'll fall all apart.
We don't want that to happen with our paper.
And you'll be so sad.
Yes, all that hard work will be ruined. So make sure your paper stays here until it's nice and dry. Put it in a spot where it's not going to be bothered. And we will check on it every day until it's nice and dry. Julia, it's been about 2 days since we put our paper out on our screen, and now...
It's dry!
It's dry! Should we see if it comes off the screen? Okay, pull it up. Let's see. Very careful.
It came up perfectly!
That's so awesome! You made a piece of paper! Wow, look at that. Now, if your paper doesn't come off your screen right away, that means it's going to need a little bit more time to dry. So you really want to be patient and make sure it's nice and dry before you pull it off of the screen. Once your paper is in this form, you can actually draw on it, you can cut it, you can treat it just like regular paper. Isn't that so cool?
Woohoo!
Yeah!
It's so cool!
It is! You could even tear it up and make new paper out of it again if you wanted. That would be a lot of work. Did you like our paper making video today? If you did, please like and subscribe. That way, every time we come out with new STEM projects, you'll be the first to know. Also, check out down below for our freebies and thewinkle.com. Juliet, thanks so much for joining me in this video today. You were such a good helper tearing all those bits of paper. It was so much work. We would love to see what you guys made. If you have a grown-up take a picture or video of you making your paper project, they could post it on social media, either Instagram or Facebook, and tag us at the Winkle Crate. That way we can see what you made and how it turned out. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye. Bye.